Hello, Mini Masters. This is our tutorial for making a lid or canister lid monster to go along with our book, Leonardo the Terrible Monster, or any monster book for the month of October. So I've made one first to show you out of a juice can lid. So these are those cans of frozen juice that you just add water to it. They have some metal lids, and these are perfect for making little monsters, especially if you want to put a magnet on the back. You just add your stuff inside the lid with the flat part facing down, and then you can get some magnets to glue on the back of the magnets. And then you can have this on your refrigerator. And you can also put any other kind of faces or decorations inside them to make magnets. So these are really perfect for different crafts. But if you don't have any of these lying around, you can also use some big plastic lids like this. These come off of juice bottles or detergent bottles. So you really only need a few things for this. So you need a couple of bottle caps here and some googly eyes. If you don't have googly eyes, you can always improvise with some pieces of the paper. And then just some black and white paper, some scissors, and some glue. So I'm gonna go onto this purple one here. And some of these have some writing on the top. This one is stamped up with something on the top. This one is not. So you can actually paint over top of this if you want. You can spray paint it, or you can leave it how it is. You could also cut a piece of paper out to fit it and put it on top if you don't want to paint, if you don't want to see that writing on top of there. So these are really, really easy. What you need to do with these is get your eyes down here. So like on my other videos, I like my monsters to have three eyeballs. I don't know why, but I like three eyeballs for monsters. So I'm gonna have some two eyeballs of the same on the outside and one the same and a different one in the middle. Okay, so there's my eyeballs. And then down here, we wanna make a little mouth. I'm gonna make it kind of like that one because I think that one is pretty funny. Actually, I might make it a little bit different. How about we make this one into more of a square? So I'm gonna make this more of a square mouth, a little bit too big. There we go, that's a good size. And you see just by doing that, it kind of covers up a little bit of the writing so you don't have to paint over top of it. Now these, you can't really put a magnet on the back unless you stack a lot of magnets because this is too deep. So these are better for the magnets, but these are fun just put around your house or for little activities that you can put inside of bags for Halloween. Instead of Halloween candy, you can get a bunch of these together and put them in a bag and then give those out to kids so they can do when they pick up their trick-or-treat candy. So then again, I'm gonna make some little triangles because I'm gonna make some little fangs. I do like my little triangle fangs. And then I'm gonna glue these to my mouth. These are kind of little, so this might be difficult for little hands, but it is a good practice in fine motor skills. Get my glue out here. There's one. I actually had a little bit too much on there, so I'm going to borrow some of it from here. There we go. There's a fang, and there's another fang. Oops, got my eyeball there. There we go. Ta-da! Two kind of different monsters, but so when the glue dries, it'll dry clear, so you don't have to worry about that little blob right there. But get creative, make different kinds of mouths and fangs and expressions and eyes. You can give them little eyebrows or give them mustaches or lips or give them some fun ears or different colors. So just get creative with your little monsters. So thank you for coming. Bye.